Hannibal. So now what I got to do in attempts to be obedient to the doctrine, you know what I got to do since the day, Shauna? I now got to go find the scripture that tells me I can't have one. I got to find scripture that tells me that I got to cut it off. I got to find the scripture that supports your doctrine. And you know what happens when I go to go find that scripture? I don't find one. I do not find one. So you know what that is under the category of? The doctrine of men. Where did Jesus teach it? Where did the apostles teach it? Where is it? It's nowhere. So it falls under the category of the doctrine of men. And it falls under the category of the doctrine of men. Guess what? I and you, because we only got 5 men in here, ain't got to listen to that joke. Amen. I didn't call it a doctrine because they know we're in the book.
That's right. Amen. That's right.
So how can we righteously preach that and condemn people for it?
Amen.
Amen.
It's doctrines of men. And you know what has just happened? They just added something that ain't there. And they teach it like Jesus said it. They teach it like the apostles preached it. But in fact, they added it. Alright. Well, let's go to the scripture that many will try to use to justify.
Come on now.
That doctrine.
Mm-hmm.
Isaiah 7
mm-hmm.
and verse number 20.
Yep.
Lord, help these people. Amen. Isaiah 7 verse number 20. I get excited about this. You got to love the truth.
Amen.
Amen. We got to become lovers of the truth.
Amen.
Isaiah 7, verse number 20.
In the same day, shall the Lord
shave with a razor.
That is hired.
Namely,
By them beyond the river.
By the king of Assyria.
The head.
Listen, y'all. I've heard you just quote this scripture. In that day, the Lord gonna shave with a razor. That's why. You brothers can't have beards. Because the Lord said he was going to shave with a razor. And what these hypocrites do, because that's what they are.
Amen.
The hypocrites stop reading.
Amen.
Amen.
And they don't continue on with the scripture.
Amen.
Because if they do, after we finish shaving our beards off, I want y'all to put some other stuff up here for me to thoroughly examine. Keep reading, brother. And the hair, he gonna shave the head He will make you completely bald.
Amen.
So before I take my beard off, I'm going to make sure all y'all Negroes bald headed. Because the Lord will shave with a razor.
Amen.
First, the head.
Amen.
All right? Then look at the next thing he going to shave.
And the hair.
And the hair.
Of the feet.
Now, Eric, take your shoes off. And let me see them toes. See, because it might not be for y'all women, but for us men, y'all know head grows on our toes.
Amen.
Y'all might not be as thick as ours. I got hair on my toes. And he said he was going to shave the head and them toes.
Amen.
And what else?
And it shall also consume.
And it shall also
consume the beard.
Oh, see, they was ready to jump and shout to get to the beard. But you done forgot the head and the toes.
Amen.
Y'all see?
Yeah.
How hypocritical we get?
Yes.
That's the very scripture that they used to justify the shaving of a beard and for men to be clean shaven. But in order for us to use that and teach that doctrine, it just taught that all of the brothers got to be bald headed and don't have no hair on their toes. So we got to walk around here
bald-headed
and bald-faced it just with a mustache. You know how dumb we be sitting around here looking? And with no hair on my toe. My wife will be sitting there looking at me like I'm Freddy Krueger. We joke. And we can have a good time because we've been illuminated.
Right.
Amen.
We've been liberated. But think about so many people that are in bondage to this garbage.
Amen.
That the Bible doesn't teach.
Amen.
They're in bondage to this stuff. Feeling condemned by wearing this. I'm so glad I got the Holy Ghost for real.
Yes.
Because I can hear them preach that garbage and it don't do nothing to the Holy Ghost in me. I've been hearing preachers preach that stuff in the pulpit for a long time and the Holy Ghost is yet to convict me to go to the barbershop and cut it off. You know why? Because when I look at the Word of God, it's not there.
Amen.
And the only thing that convicts me is the Word of God.
That's right.
Amen.
I cannot be convicted by men's doctrines. All right, there's another one, and I'm getting out of here. I ain't gonna be able to get to the other list, but I got a whole other list of some doctrines that we got to address. Ezra 9 and 1. Ezra 9 and 1. Because you got to be fair if you're gonna use scripture to show where they have beards. It was a shame for the beards to be cut off. You still got to use scripture that does still talk about something, at least remotely to something with a razor. But when you read it in this context, you realize it's not saying that at all. Ezra,
now, 9:1. Now when these things were done, the princes came to me,
saying,
the people of Israel,
and the priests,
and the Levites,
have not separated themselves from the people of the land,
doing according to their abominations,
even of the Canaanites,
the Hittites,
the Perizzites,
the Jebusites,
the Ammonites,
the Moabites,
the Egyptians,
and the Amorites.
For they have taken up their daughters for themselves,
and for their sons,
so that the holy seed
have mingled themselves
with the people of those lands.
Yea. The head of the princes
and rulers
have been chief in this trespass.
Uh-huh.
And when I heard this thing.
Now listen to this, y'all. And when I heard this thing,
I rent my garment. And my mantle. And plucked off the hair of my head. And of my beard. And sat down. A stone. Then were assembled unto me.
This shows a symbol of humiliation.
Amen.
To pluck out the hair of your beard, to pluck out the hair of your head, to rent your garment, were symbols and signs of humbling oneself.
Right, right.
Humiliating oneself, breaking oneself down.
Amen.
That's what that symbolized. Pulling out your hands of your head, pulling out your hair, rent your garment, all that type of stuff. That's all the Bible shows us. It never shows us we're doing that was praised in regards of holiness. In order for you to be holy, you got to shave all this off and be clean cut. Because that's what it requires to be holy. Nowhere. And I got more scriptures that I'm looking at. And when I looked at them, I found it. No way. Every scripture that talked about a razor was talking about something totally different. And whenever they started talking about it, it always included the head.
Right.
With the beard.
Okay.
So who are we to separate? The two. If we got to shave this, we got to shave this too. Nowhere, y'all. Nowhere. So where we get it from? Men. Get it from men. And men are messing up God's church. Teaching stuff that they ought not to be teaching. From this sacred desk. Because when you teach it from here, you got to make sure it's the doctrine of Christ and not the doctrine of a man. Because what you'll start doing is that you'll start putting that doctrine so high up to where you start condemning people and looking at people differently when they don't conform to your doctrine.
Amen.
And when you put them under condemnation, you put yourself in a position that God never placed you in.
Amen.
When God's word said, there is therefore now no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus, that walk after the Spirit and not after the flesh. We cannot bring people into things that Jesus Christ himself never condemned us for.
Amen.
When we do that, we have overridden Jesus Christ's authority. Jesus said, I came not to condemn the world, but the world through me might be saved. For there's one that's going to judge and condemn the world in the end. My word.
Amen.
And we in the church are putting things on people that bring them into condemnation prematurely. Things that Christ have not put them under condemnation for.
Amen. Amen.
Who gives us the authority?
Who?
Who gives us the right to do that?
That's right.
The devil.
And
people better be careful.
Amen.
People better be careful.
Amen.
Because the only one that brings folks into condemnation is the enemy.
That's right.
Because when Christ died on that cross, he justified us. He removed the condemnation off of us. That's what the blood of Jesus Christ is all about. And to now let these Johnny-come-latelys bring me into condemnation for something that Jesus Christ and his apostles ain't never taught and never said. The devil is a liar.
Amen. Amen.
And it makes me want to grow minds a little bit longer. Amen. Make me want to grow minds a little bit longer. Because they're bringing you into condemnation. It's something that the Bible does not condemn us for. And I'm not talking about one particular group of people. Because when I teach and preach, I'm not talking about one individual. Because the fact of the matter is, it's just not one person teaching this type of stuff.
Amen.
There are multiple apostolic brethren that are preaching this stuff from the pulpit. Saying it as if it's truth. And making us that are not abiding in that doctrine feel like they're condemned. Feel like they're condemned. And that's sad. I thought we came to the house of God to be liberated.
That's right.
Amen. Amen.
That's right.
We came to Jesus to be liberated.
Amen.
We did not come to Jesus to be put back in a different type of bondage.
Amen.
We were in bondage when we were in sin.
Amen.
And he came in order to deliver us and tells us to not be entangled in the yoke of bondage again. But after we get untangled from the yoke of bondage, we come into the apostolic holiness church just to be put back in a different type of bondage.
That's the truth.
So you took me out of the bondage of the world and brought me out of the bondage of the church. Where's the liberty? Where's the liberty? The Bible said, but the Spirit of the Lord is
liberty.
There is liberty. When I came over this way, I became free to live in Christ Jesus. I was dead when I was in the world. I was dead in sin and in trespasses. We were dead. When we came over on this house as a jury, we came to get life.
Amen.
And that more abundantly. I refused to be dead all them years in the world and come right into God's house just to become dead all over again.
Amen.
Amen.
I got liberty now. And my liberty doesn't mean I can do whatever I want to do as pertaining to sin. But that liberty has brought me in to a position to be able to live. And to live without condemnation. I'm free to live. Free of being condemned. Then why do we condemn everything in the church?
Amen.
Now we're walking around here because I got a short sleeve shirt on. Oh, my Lord.
Come on.
If one of the saints see me out in the street like this, condemnation. Oh, I'm wearing these color pants. Oh, if the saints see me, condemnation. I'm in the grocery store with flip-flops on and no stockings. If the saints see me, condemnation. I'm out in the street, out and about with my head uncovered. Condemnation. We walk around in holiness more bound up than we're free. But the Lord came to liberate us. And the Lord sent me to the apostolic church like Moses to tell Pharaoh, let my people go.
Jesus.
Hold us to what the Bible says, and that's it.
It. Amen. That's right.
Amen.
We got liberty. Somebody walking around peeking over their shoulder.
It's true.
Trying to see who watching them. That's why some of us can't praise the Lord in the church. I'm letting y'all go. That's why we can't praise the Lord, because we looking over our shoulder.
Yeah.
Amen.
Who think we faking? Who think we putting on?
Amen.
Who won't say something about me? Amen. That's what we live in fear of other people's opinions.
Amen.
When we come into fellowship, everybody walking around on eggshells because we don't know what to do. Because if we do something out of the way, they're going to think of us in this life. They're going to say we not in holiness. They're going to condemn us for what we say. And now everybody walking around like mummies, like puppets and mummies in the house of God. Don't know what they can do. We sit around in fellowship, don't even talk to one of the quad. If I tell a joke, you joking and jesting. You too worried. Every time something comes out your mouth, somebody got something to say about it. If you laugh too loud, somebody gonna condemn you for it. If you sit there with a frown on your face, somebody gonna think you're upset with a nasty attitude. Everything got judgment with it.
Right.
So we don't know what to do.
It's the truth. It's the truth.
So everybody walking around the house of God like mothers. Hey Lord. Don't nobody know what to do. And that's why the majority of these church folks don't like to sit around and have fellowship after service and want they can go back to their house so they can be free to do what they want to do. Because when they get around you, they don't know what they can do. So they quick, fast, in a hurry to get home, to let their hair down, take off their shoes, and relax them toes that you got stuck up in them shoes, that you won't let them wear no open-toed shoes or no sandals, so they get home so they can kick them bad boys off because my toes sweat.
Amen.
Better not. I got this long skirt on.
Amen.
And you gonna tell me to put stockings on top of it and put them inside clothes, toes, shoes, and it's 100 degrees outside with my head wrapped up. You are walking heat stroke. Oh, I forgot, and you can't. So you got your long sleeves on.
You got your stockings on.
With your stockings on.
Amen.
With your toes crunched up in the shoes. And your head covered, and it's 100 degrees. And then when you pass out dehydrated somewhere, then we plead the blood of Jesus. No Negro, sit down and go get some understanding. The Bible said they have a zeal, but it's not according to knowledge. Can't convince me that's knowledgeable. That's foolishness.
Jesus.
And holiness church have been doing it for years, and then wonder why don't nobody want to come to holiness.
Amen.
If I got to be walking, if I got to be a walking heat stroke, I'm staying in the Baptist church.
Amen.
At least over there I can be cool. And when you talk like this, folks thinking you say holiness is not right. Holiness is right.
Yes, right.
But
yes,
your version of holiness ain't right.
Yes.
God got a way.
Yes.
And we got to do it God's way.
God's way. He tells you how.
Long as y'all ain't showing all your nooks and crannies, letting people see stuff that only your husband or your wife should see, you
Amen.
Have liberty to wear.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
You know you got the Holy Ghost. You know when it's too short.
Yeah, that's right.
You know when it's too
tight. That's right.
You know when cleavage showing.
That's right. Yes,
you got know. A mirror and you got a friend. You know.
That's right.
Amen.
And I don't need to sit here and tell you and remind you about how you ought to dress in holiness.
That's right.
Amen. Neither do I need to put no pamphlet together.
That's right.
Amen.
And have you put something up on your wall to remind you every day when you get up in the morning, before you walk out of the house, you better read the manual. You ain't no cop. You don't need no manual to see how this works.
Amen.
know what you've been taught. You know what holiness is. You abide in holiness. And the rest of that stuff, leave it alone.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Leave it alone. Thank y'all for bearing with me and my father.
Amen.
Amen.
Some other stuff that needs to be addressed.
Amen.
But somebody got to say, if we don't say nothing, we're going to let this foolishness keep being preached. Like it's been being preached for years.
Amen.
In the holiness church, and we've misrepresented God.
Amen.
Misrepresented God for so long. As hot as it is up in here, I couldn't be under no wool hat if I was you. You better go find you something silky to bring a little cool breeze up in there.
Amen.
That's right. That's right.
Confining people all day long to wool hats, and that's the only thing you can wear. Pulling your hair out. And they don't wisdom.
Amen.
Then, let me tell y'all something. Then I know what the saints did. Then the saints put on the wool hats, and them saints ain't dumb. Them saints know if you're pulling their hair out.
Uh-huh.
So therefore, what they do, they're going to put a trash bag. Put a little grocery bag, stuff it up in there.
Yeah. Or a tissue.
And then put it up on a tissue.
Uh-huh.
And you put it up on their head so it don't pull their hair out.
Uh-huh.
And then even that is adding more heat.
Yes.
And wonder why you preaching the word and they falling asleep because they hot. They don't know all that heat. Making that thing feel like they underneath somebody's hair drying.
Uh-huh.
Like they never put, it's hot underneath
yes.
there.
Yes.
I seen mothers in the church for years stuffing their hats with tissue, other stuff, with paper bags to put on their head so it wouldn't pull the hair out. Add extra stuff so it won't pull the hair out. And then on it, I would just simply say, why don't you just get something else?
That's right, something cool.
To cover your head with. Why? Because they told you you couldn't. Nothing but a hat. That's not no any old kind of hat. Had to be a wool hat.
Uh-huh.
Couldn't be a straw hat. Couldn't be no this hat. Had to be this type of hat.
The tam with the little thing on top.
And them things is hot.
Amen.
Amen. There's a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And there's just some things you just shouldn't cross.
Amen.
Some things you just shouldn't cross.
Yep. Amen.
Some things you just should not add.
That's right.
Women, cover your heads.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And whatever you find to cover it with, as long as it's in the confines of Scripture, cover your heads with prayer and prophecy. I ain't going to sit here and tell you what to cover it with. Just make sure it's covered.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And covered properly.
Amen.
Amen.
But all this hats and no hats and no prayer cloths and only it's too much.
Amen.
Entirely too much. Alright. Alright, y'all. We're gonna get into some more trouble. But it's all good. I don't mind being here.
Amen.
Enough is enough.
Got to use wisdom.
Enough is enough.
Amen.
That's right.
Because some of them same ones, they got all that stuff on. It's gonna be even hotter when they find themselves right there in the lake of fire.
Amen.
My Lord.
That stuff will help. That will almost catch on fire quick. It's going to grab it and take the fire to them. And we're going to put all them rules and regulations upon them, and they still won't be lost.
Yeah.
Still won't be lost.
Miserable.
Because they follow a tradition.
Yeah.
Of a man, not the word of God. Put your hands together. Let me get out of here.